School. Place that I'd like to start out. My name is Starlin Roddy. I'm a new success coach here at MCC. I've only been here for about, this is going on my third month. So, with that being said, what do y'all think a success coach does?
Helps out.
Helps out. How do they help out?
Help you be a successful coach.
There you go. There you go. As you notice, we're not called failure coaches. That's not our goal. We ain't gonna just call, we want to set you up for success, not for failure. That is one of the biggest things that we look for here on campus. So with that being said, what do you feel like you need in order to be successful? We're at the halfway mark. What do you feel like it takes to succeed here in college?
Taking your own time.
Huh?
Taking your own time.
Your time management, your work. Go to classes, do work.
Listen.
Something you don't do. On every occasion. You know, because these are all things that you need in order to be successful. How many of y'all are first semester students? This is your first go around. All y'all. So for y'all said get her on time, show up to classes. What was the most difficult thing for y'all the first go around here at college?
Figuring
out where classes are. Waking up. Because let's be honest, you know, when you're in high school, you feel like, hey, somebody gonna get me up, somebody gonna show me where to go, it's all set and planned out for you, you ain't gotta worry about it, you don't show up to class, you get in trouble. But when you're in college, what's up?
I don't think it's that, I just think it's a lot of responsibility.
A lot of responsibility, which it is. Because guess what, you ain't got somebody saying, hey, you need to get there. You ain't got that bell that rings that tells you to go from class to class to class. And guess what, oftentimes, you don't have teachers that's gonna be like, you gonna do your work or not. They're gonna be like, we got paid. Y'all here? Either you're gonna turn it in or you're not. But let's be honest, at a lot of college campuses, they don't care. I'll be honest with you. Be honest. Here at MCC, they care quite a bit. So, you know, they'll check in on you, they'll email you, or they'll send us a referral. Let us know, hey, would you mind checking in on this student? Will you see how they're doing? Will you see how everything is going? So to be honest, they do care. Man, I almost knew this. Y'all swear? Put you on there late. What did we just talk about?
Success.
Being on time. Then you come here before you got enough for everybody. Like you ever seen a Whataburger commercial? You want to make friends, you gotta come in late, you gotta bring a Whataburger for everybody. But no, these are all things that you need in order to be successful here on campus. These are some of the things that helps you be successful here on campus. So, with that being said, how do you feel like us as success coaches can help? What can we do to help you be better here on campus?
Mentor or like talk.
There you go. We can mentor and we can catch it. We can mentor you or we can talk to you. They shape like this for a reason, man. No, but we try to do the best that we can to mentor and help. As I say, one of the biggest things that we believe in, that we strive for, is that as success coaches, we care about you. We want to form a relationship with you, but we also want to provide resources with you. We care about you outside of school. We don't care about you just educationally, but we care about you mentally, emotionally. We understand that some of y'all are brothers, fathers, mothers, daughters, aunts, uncles. There are more to it than just being a college student. Sometimes it's hard to get off work, working nights, and come up to a 9:35 class. We understand that can be difficult. We understand that can be hard. So what we try to do is to provide you with resources that will help you out along the way. That is one of the biggest things that we try to do for you guys. So with that being said, we help you out with academic planning, with time management, with stress, with test taking strategies, things of that nature. Things that you may need here in order to succeed on campus. So, since you're at the halfway mark, what do you feel like is your favorite class? Which class do you like the most?
Yeah.
Don't say that because you think you're going to get a good grade. You can be honest if you don't like it. This one. What is it that you like about this class?
It's not innovation.
It's not what? Got you. It's out the norm. It's not your basic core classes that you have to take. Okay, anybody else?
We always do hands-on stuff, so you learn to work better.
No doubt. That makes sense. Because the thing is, we got a lot of students that I've seen where they're like, all we get is handouts. Sometimes teachers don't walk around. They don't let us do anything. They don't allow us the opportunity to meet and greet or to figure it out on our own, put our hands on. So that is another thing. What else?
Group.
Makes sense. To be honest, they say that one of the best ways to learn is to learn from your peers. When you do group teaching, when you do interact with your other students. Why? Because who likes that teacher that's just going to sit up in front of class and talk nonstop all day?
I'm just putting you to sleep, honestly.
Exactly. But when you're in groups, you can learn from your fellow students. All right, so tell me about the class that you do not like the most.
Math.
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 Okay, girl, make it strong. Say, read and write, man, man. Math.
Read, write, and sleep.
Read, write, and sleep. Because see, the thing is that with math, a lot of people like math because they feel like it's concrete. There's only one way to get a solution, meaning it is always going to be this answer. So that's why they like math. So I'm going to teach you a study strategy. Right now, one of the best things that you can do is you always study your homework or the class that you dislike the most first. You do that one first. Why? Because you already have the energy to do it. You already have the energy, the buildup to do it. Now, you say your least, your most favorite class last. Why? Because it won't feel like homework. You'll feel like, all right, I got something to look forward to. I get there, I do it, done. Now, if you say your least favorite class for last, you're just going to get to it, all right, yeah, You got 20 pages, but you're going to read all of them in less than 5 minutes. You're just going to run through it. You're just going to scan through it. Oh, I got this.
I read thicker books. I read thicker books, and I read them within like 20 minutes.
There you go.
I'm like halfway through the book.
I do that too, but that's the stuff that I don't like reading. I do it real quick, real fast. So, when you have the most energy, when you have the most gumption to do it, you do it first. So, with that being said, what are some ways that you can meet a success coach? I told you one of them. Huh? To meet a success coach? You could study to meet us? That's stalking. That's what that is. What was that we said, referral?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
I tried. I gave my best. I gave my whole college try.
That wasn't much.
One of the ways that you can meet us is through a referral. As I said before, sometimes teacher, faculty, or staff will send us a referral asking that you meet with us. And with that being said, y'all not in trouble when that's the case. If you get an email or text message from us just checking up on you, that doesn't mean that we're like, hey, you did something wrong in class, what's going on? It may be, hey, you haven't shown up to class for 2 or 3 days. It's more concern than anything. You know, hey, what's up with you being late? And guess what? We understand the various reasons for why you are late or why you can't make it to class. Whether you have a car trouble, whether your child is sick, whether you're struggling with daycare. Things of that nature we understand and we respect. So, what is another way that you can meet us?
Just go.
Yes, you can Pop-Tart us. That's what we like to call Pop-Tart. You just show up. Just pop up. I promise you, we will be there for you. If we're busy, we will schedule a time to meet with you one-on-one. Alright? So, yes, you can just show up randomly. You know, like that crazy ex-boyfriend or girlfriend. They'll just come knock on your door. But that's okay.
They
can have your seat.
They were late.
I like y'all, we'd be happy to see y'all. All right, what's another way?
Call.
You give us a shout. But the thing is, again, we will not do y'all like y'all do us. We will not send y'all straight to voicemail like y'all do us when we call. All right, we will not look at the blinking button when y'all call. All right, there's one more. One more way.
Email.
Send us email. Again, we will not do y'all like y'all do us. We will not send y'all email to spam. We will not leave it unread like y'all do on Facebook. All right? We will actually see it, and we will get in contact with you. Those are one of the things, those are the ways that y'all get in contact with us. Over there, first of all, do y'all know where we're located at?
Yeah.
No,
we're the seasoners. Yeah, but you go in the door and turn around.
What's the name of the building?
Student Service Center.
Student Service Center.
Well, I was like, getting out.
I'm not going to catch it.
I'm not
going to
catch it.
You can catch it.
I'm not
going to
catch it.
What you scared for? There you go.
Thank you.
Yes.
This is something I can tell them I need to do. Fiance.
But yes, we're located at the Student Service Center. So basically what it is over at the Testa Center. We're up top on the second floor where you met your advisors. Things of that nature, we're right across the hall. What else? There's also different levels for different types of success coaches. Basically, we have a financial aid success coach. His name is Brandon Hoy. What he does is, if you need some assistance with your financial aid, now is he a walkie-talkie financial aid office? No.
Yes.
Yeah, he is. But at the same time, for like superficial or surface things that you need done or questions that you have with financial aid, go and see Brandon. Next up, we have social worker, success coach. We're in the process of getting a new one, but basically if you need outside resources outside of the school, whether it's with food, daycare, or things of that nature, things that'll help you succeed, transportation, he or she will connect you with the resources that you need outside of the community. We also have your general success coach, who helps out with a variety of things. That'll be me. Granted, I'm new. If I don't have the answers for your questions, I'll be more than happy to help. We also have the disability success coach. Her name is Laura Carruthers. If you have a non-disability, a documented disability, go see her and she'll do everything that she can to help you out. Whether it is you need more time for test taking, if you need a recorder to listen to lectures, she got you. Another program that we have is the SEP program. It is the Support and Empowerment Program. It is for single parents. And that means single fathers as well. Single fathers and single mothers. Basically, they help you out with, if you need daycare, transportation. It is a program that helps you as a student get on your feet and help you succeed here in college. All right, next up, how many of y'all have heard of the food pantry?
I actually heard about that from a friend of mine.
All right, what do you think about it? What did you hear about it?
I live in a different town, so it's like a 30-minute drive all the way up to here to that chair. And a friend of mine, he just told us about the food pantry, and I didn't even know about it.
Because I'll be honest with you, when I was in college, I wish I knew about the food pantry. I got tired of eating ramen noodles and volume of sausages and cornflakes, you know, throughout the semester. You know, because I'll be honest with you, I'll be here, y'all be thinking about partying, y'all be worried about food too. Y'all be hearing a little bit. No. That was me for a certain semester. Food was last on my list. Y'all see, I'll be asking about y'all food, paying for it now. But the thing is with the food pantry is that it is open Monday through Friday from 12 to 1. At the same time, we understand that y'all are more than students. So if you need to come earlier in the day or even after 1, just come to the completion center. We'd be more than happy to take care of it. Basically, the food pantry is open to all students, regardless of how much you make, your income. We go by your family size, your household. We have you fill out a small form. Doesn't affect whether you get food or not. It's just for statistical purposes. And basically what it is that we have fresh fruit, sometimes fresh meat. We have beans, we have a little bit of everything to help you out with beans. Like I say, when my stomach touched my back, I wish I knew about it. It helps out a great deal. Because let's be honest, you can't study. You're not worried about your school if you're hungry. If you're hungry, you can care less about what you make on the grade. Care less about your attention span in class. So that is one of the biggest things that we offer here on campus that I recommend that you take advantage of. Okay, one of the other things that we're trying to hook you guys up with is the Center of Academic Excellence. Y'all know where that's located at? Police station was the furthest thing I was trying to know where it was at.
Yeah.
y'all paying a little bit too much attention.
I'm good, so.
Nah, but you're absolutely right. It's right next to the police station. Basically, what they do is they hook you up with two. Whether that is computer skills, for y'all that hate math, they got y'all. Whether it is for reading and writing, they got y'all. Now, again, we are in college. Why do I feel like that's important? Because how many of y'all was in high school and was like, I ain't going no tutoring. Care about no tutoring. I ain't gonna let them see me go no tutoring. I don't care. I'm dumb, but I look good though. I got on blue jays. I care less. Look, when you're in college, you gotta hear how you live. You know, do you want that grade or not? Do you want that help or not? Because guess what? As teachers, I'm gonna be hearing about this what happened when you have the resources provided for you. So the Center of Academic Excellence is a wonderful resource. Another thing is that I meant to ask, speaking of your teachers, how many of y'all have a good relationship with your teachers? How many of y'all talk to your teachers? How many of y'all?
Like me.
What you do?
I tell them that you think things are different than they really are. Like, yes, he got offended.
Well, wouldn't you get offended too?
I mean, he was. That probability, he was just solving it, like, in a. Just a hard way.
So you feel like that you can just express it to him. Did you express it to him after class or in front of the
whole? No, I didn't
say
it in front of the class. I did not say that
because
that would
be really
good.
So there's room to bring it up.
I asked him not here so we could talk about it.
Okay.
But he was like, I've been doing this for 20 years. He's like, if you have your opinion, I respect it. I said, I'm not going to do it. Because I'm not. Like, everybody that sits around me, they feel like you're too. So I was just like, well, they have to say that.
So you took a leadership role. Well, the thing is, we live and we learn. Lord knows I've had teachers where I've bumped heads with a plan. And to be quite honest, you'll be surprised at how many teachers respect your honesty when you do bring up certain things. That's why they have conference hours, but also student evaluations. The reason why I ask if you have a good relationship with your teachers is because most likely you will still have that relationship with them outside of school. Now, once you graduate, once you move on, you may need that letter of recommendation. You may need that teacher to say, hey, do you think you can, I can use you as a reference for this job? Just think about it. When you're in school, they see you more than just about sometimes your own family does. Sometimes more than your own kids do. Your other employers. Some of y'all go to school full time. You're not able to work. So who is better to be your point of reference than your teacher? That's the reason why I say it's important. But it's good that you at least talk to them. So that's all it is. That being said, okay, what else do we offer? Y'all know about the library and I'll talk about the food pantry. How many of y'all go to the library? I mean to actually do work.
Oh, just play.
What is it that you like about the library? Squat? What else?
Let's go for brain.
Go for brain.
It's like too quiet.
Okay.
I all like
the library?
If I do, then I'll get like one of those rooms.
Is it too quiet?
Yes, I feel like I'm going to hear me take it. That's why I go into that academic
center. Academic.
Yeah.
Okay. So you like a little bit of motion. You like to see things going on. Because if it's too quiet, it's just feel like I'm comfortable. Okay. I know I have some students there, they just go to the library and people watch. You know, the little rocking chairs over by the windows. Y'all ain't never seen?
Yeah,
I've seen people staring outside the window.
Oh, see?
These people want.
For real. That's what they do. They go over and just roast people. That's just one of them or whatever. That's the only thing they do. So, but the library is a great tool to use. Like I say, just for printing alone. You know, for stuff like you ain't got to worry about your ink, your paper at the house. You can just do it all at the library.
I go in there and I get distracted. I think it's too far. I can't.
You could just like zone out.
Okay. So, do you prefer to study? Where do you prefer
to
study?
Well, I have to go to New York because I'm not going to do it at home.
Okay.
I mean, I'll do it at home if like, I got to, but I would focus more on it if I do it at school.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I will probably put it on everything. I get distracted.
But at the same time, it goes back to what we said. Again, your time management, your attention level. You know where you can and can't do your homework at. That says a lot. Because some people be like, yeah, I do it when I get home. Next thing you know, Lord have mercy, whatever reality TV show is on, Love and Hip Hop, you know, come on, guess what? They're gonna watch it, the press news or whatever, they're gonna watch it, then I get to it here in a minute. Get all about it. So it is about finding your happy space to study. That is very important. Alright, so we also help out with study skills, like I say. Another thing y'all talk about is the counseling service. Do y'all know where the counseling center is located at?
Yeah.
Who said math? Yes, it's in the math building. Yes, this is very important. I used to counsel there before I started here, during my practical intern when I went to the university. It is a very good resource to have. And the reason why I say that is because people are like, I don't want to do counseling. I'm perfect. I'm great. I'm fine. But at the end of the day, it goes back to what we talked about before. You are a student. You are a mother. You are a daughter. You have other stressors than the main thing, which sometimes untreated can lead to depression. With depression comes sometimes suicidal ideations, things of that nature. Now, if you were to go see a counselor or a therapist outside of school, since I work at a private practice, said, well, no insurance is going to cost you about $100 an hour. Right off the rip. That includes no insurance at all, period. But we have a counselor sitting here, which you can use for absolutely free. Now, people are like, oh, well, I got friends. I got family I can talk to, which is great. But sometimes it doesn't hurt to have a neutral party that will tell you or listen to you, at least. Sometimes us as people get tired of hearing people, but they got to tell us, we just want people to listen. That's what counseling is about. So that is why I feel like that is very important. There are over, if I'm not mistaken, 1,400, a little over 1,400 community colleges here in the United States, yet less than 25% of them have a counseling center. Less than that, even have a counseling center on site. So, again, that is something I feel like that y'all should take advantage of if you have the opportunity to. Alright? Let's see here. I think we are just about done. We also have, like I said, math and science lab. Alabama Central. We also have a community clinic that you can all check and look into. So let me ask you this. One thing, what do you feel like success coaches are not? What is it that we don't do?
Give you rides home.
Yes, that is correct. We're not Waymo Transit. You're not Uber. What else? How do you do everything?
Come bring me something special.
But Loretta, we are not we're not counselors. Now, can we help you out with some surface things that you're dealing with? Sure. We'll be more than happy to. If you need a place just to get upset about or talk about that teacher or to cry, whatever, y'all can feel free to come into our office and we'll be more than happy to listen to. We're not financial aid. We're not a whole list of other things. Not academic advisors. Granted, you can get in touch with your academic advisor, look at your schedule, see what kind of work best for you. We're not that as well. Basically, we do a little bit of everything, but we're not just one thing. That being said, do anyone have any questions?
Ask one of those cooks.
Think about next class. I'm sorry. Which one you want?
Orange.
Orange.
Orange is one of those cooks.
Y'all have any other questions? Orange or blue?
Okay. Wow.
Can I tell them this time like I did the star? Which one would you like? Orange.
Oh,
which blue one? That's a lot of blues. Hunt. You said hunt. What you gonna go kill besides humans?
Hey, just a second.
Don't know.
Yeah, there we go.